Knoxville, Omaha, Bucca, Shepherdville, Jacksonville, Waterville, Coast, Arima, Pittsfield, Springfield, Bakersfield, Shreveport, Hackensack, Cadillac, Fond du Lac, Davenport, Idaho, Jellicoe, Argentina, Diamantina, Pasadena, Catalina, Sequoia. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert, it's bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. Of travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. I've been to Pittsburgh, Parkersburg, Gravelburg, Colorado, Ellensburg, Rexburg, Vicksburg, Eldorado, Larimore, Atmore, Havistaw, Chattanooga, Chasta, Nebraska, Alaska, Opelika, Baraboo, Waterloo, Kalamazoo, Kansas City, Sioux City, Cedar City, Dodge City, what a pity. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the desert, bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I've traveled, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
A stop sign, you got a stop sign, you were here first, go.
Well, my daddy left home when I was 3 and he didn't leave much for Ma and me, just this old guitar and an empty bottle of booze.
You get a double car.
Now, I don't blame him because he run and hid, but the meanest thing that he ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. Well, he must have thought that it was quite a joke and it got a lot of laughs from lots of folks. Seems I had to fight my whole life through. Some gal would giggle and I'd get red, and some guy'd laugh and I'd bust his head. I tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. Well, I grew up quick and I grew up mean. My fists got hard, my wits got keen. Roamed from town to hide my shame. But I made me a vow to the moon and stars, I'd search the honky-tonks and bars and kill that man and give me that awful name. Well, it was Gatlinburg in mid-July and I'd just hit town and my throat was dry. I thought I'd stop and have myself a brew. At an old saloon on a street of mud, there at a table dealing stud, sat the dirty mangy dog that named me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was my own sweet dad from a worn-out picture that my mother'd had. And I knew that scar on his cheek and his evil eye. He was big and bent and gray and old. And I looked at him and my blood ran cold. And I said, my name is Sue. How do you do? How are you gonna die? Yeah, that's what I told him. Well, I hit him hard right between the eyes and he went down, but to my surprise, come up with a knife and cut off a piece of my ear. But I busted a chair right across his teeth and we crashed through the wall and into the street, kicking and a gouging in the mud and the blood and the beer. I tell you, I've fought tougher men, but I really can't remember when. He kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. I heard him laugh and then I heard him cuss and he went for his gun to pull mine first. He stood there looking at me and I saw him smile. He said, son, this world is rough and if a man's gonna make it, he's gotta be tough. And I know I wouldn't be there to help you along. So I give you that name and I said goodbye. I knew you'd have to get tough or die. And it's that name that helped to make you strong. Yeah. He said, now you just fought one hell of a fight, and I know you hate me, and you got the right to kill me now, and I wouldn't blame you if you do. But you ought to thank me before I die for the gravel in your guts and the spit in the eye, because I'm the that named you Sue. Yeah, what could I do? What could I do? I got all choked up, and I threw down my gun, called him a paw, and he called me a son. And I come away with a different point of view. And I think about him now and then, every time I try and every time I win. And if I ever have a son, I think I'm gonna name him Bill or George, anything but Sue. I really ain't that man.
Greatest songs ever written.
All right, thank you very much. Just before we ask the Statler brothers to come back out, we'd like to ask the Carter family and Carl to help us out on a fine spiritual that we've got a lot of requests to do. Peace in the battle. I met her at the laundromat. She was washing extra hot. I said, don't you need a little help with that big load you got? She said no, but did a double take, and then she smiled and said, I might. As I rolled up my sleeves, I said to myself, well, all right, well, all right. I put it on automatic, and she sat down on the floor. She said, just keep it on medium hot. I said, I've done this before. Then I opened up the dryer and I set it on soft and light. She said, be gentle with my silk and lace. And I said, well, all right. Well, all right. Her clothes are in the basket, folded down so nice and warm. She headed for the door and I said, I will take you home. She said, I just live up the street. I said, it's a dangerous night. Take my arm and I'll carry the basket. And she said, well, all right, well, all right. The world's half full of women and the world's half full of men. And sometimes one or the other opens up to let one in. But the one I met at the laundromat that dangerous, beautiful night said, yes, I do, and yes, I will. And I said, well, all right. Well, all right. Early one morning while making the rounds, I took a shot of cocaine and I shot my woman down. I went right home and I went to bed. I stuck at 11:44 beneath my head. Got up next morning and I grabbed that gun, took a shot of cocaine and away I run. Made a good run, but I run too slow. They overtook me down in Juarez, Mexico. Laid in the hot joints, taking the pills. In walked the sheriff from Jericho Hill. He said, Willie Lee, your name is not Jack Brown. You're the dirty hack that shot your woman down. And yes, oh yes, my name is Willie Lee. If you've got a warrant, just to read it to me. Shut her down because she made me slow. I thought I was her daddy, but she had five more. When I was arrested, I was dressed in black. They put me on a train and they took me back. Had no friend for to go my bail. They slapped a dead carcass in that county jail. Early next morning, about a 9:30, I spied a sheriff coming down the line. Up and he coughed as he cleared his throat. He said, come on, you dirty hack, into that district court. Into the courtroom my trial began, where I was handled by 12 honest men. Just before the jury started out, I saw that little judge come as to look about. In about 5 minutes in walked a man, holding the verdict in his right hand. The verdict read in the first degree. I hollered, Lordy, Lordy, have mercy on me. The judge, he smiled as he picked up his pen. 99 years in the Folsom pen. 99 years underneath that ground. I can't forget today I shut that bad bitch down. Come on, you gotta listen unto me. Lay off that whiskey and let that cocaine be.
These men have receptions, Matlock, A50632, and Bat Shelter, A39879. They have receptions.
Yeah, I doubt that.
An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies. And up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky. For he saw the riders coming hard and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi-yo. Their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught them yet. 'Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. All the horses snorting fire as they ride on, hear their cry. As the rider floated on by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell riding on our range, then cowboy, change your ways. If they are with us, you will ride. Trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies.
Thank you.
Yippee-yi-yo.
Send your kin folks to
give me no talking. I'll be gone, like I said. You'd say the same old thing that you've been saying all along. Lay there in your bed, keep your mouth shut till I'm gone. Don't give me that old familiar cry and cuss and moan. Understand, you old man, I'm tired of your bad mouthing. Understand, you old man. Slow down my traveling while I'm untangled and my mind.